Sue reminds me of the man in Basel. It's because he says, okie dokie.
Morning, Hannah.
Morning.
Hello.
Hiya. How's everyone? All right?
Good. Very good. Thank you. How are you?
Yeah, looking forward to some really nice weather now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Be out there sunning yourselves.
Hi, Christine.
Hello.
Morning, Christine.
I have a swollen face. I had a big tooth taken out yesterday and I've got a huge lump here now.
Oh, dear.
Well, actually, I had the tooth actually taken out last Monday, but all they got was the top. And I had to see a dental surgeon yesterday to get the root out.
Oh, that's really failing.
So I've got stitches in the gum.
Oh, God.
But she was very good. She knew exactly what she was doing, different from the girl who actually took the tooth out or didn't take the tooth out, because she, I'm never going there again, let's say that. And then she had the cheek to charge me for half a tooth to come out.
Oh, no.
I mean, you don't charge for half, if you haven't got it out, then you don't charge.
No.
Did you pay?
No, we got the money back.
Oh, good.
Hannah, you're in the dark.
I know, the lights are on. Nobody. Oh, maybe I'll just have to come closer.
Because you've got a lot of light behind you and not enough light on your face.
Yeah.
That's all right. You don't need to see my face.
Yes, we do.
We're so jolly.
Well, we're sitting in the conservatory.
Well, the garden room.
Garden room, we call it.
Oh, garden room. Very gosh.
That's what I was thinking. Very nice, Joan.
Lovely that it doesn't have a glass roof on it anymore.
Oh, probably a good idea at the moment with the heat coming through. It would be rather warm.
Well, this faces north, so you don't normally...
Oh, you're right.
Yes, but this time of the year, the sun shines on it.
Oh, gosh.
Strange, isn't
it? Oh, hi. Yeah. Oh, wow.
We sit in the study, and we've got the windows down one side, so thus I get the light.
Yeah, Chris is sort of in the gloom.
Yeah, he's just on the other side. Yeah, but it's easier to sit at the computer, so that's why we do it. Anyway, no need to go abroad, really, is there, with all this stuff?
No, we've got some really lovely weather at home. I'm doing a family Christmas lunch. That's great, isn't it? Not bad.
Oh, wow.
We might be sitting in the garden with our crackers and Christmas hats on.
Barbecue Christmas lunch.
Yeah, I think it will be.
You're in Australia, Sally.
Yeah, could do. Oh, it's winter out there, though, isn't it? So.
Not at Christmas.
I was thinking, really.
No, my sister lives out there, and it took her a while to get used to having hot Christmases.
I did have a sister out there.
Excuse me.
No, Richard. We have an ex-brother-in-law and a niece and a nephew that live in Australia.
Oh, have you ever visited them?
No.
It's a long trip, isn't it? A long trip.
Well, at the time when it would have been appropriate to have gone, we didn't have the money.
No.
And at our age now, I don't feel like it.
No, quite. Well, my sister went on the £10 package that they had at the very beginning. And she could fly then, didn't have to go by boat.
Really?
Yeah, she could.
Well, that was lucky because most people had to go by boat, didn't
they? Yeah, they did. Yes, they did. Yeah.
Do you visit, Sally? Do you visit her?
Yes, we did. We got caught in the pandemic when it first happened out there. That was when we were last there. And we were hoping to go next year, But the likelihood is they're not going to let us into Australia for a long while because their vaccine is appalling.
Terrible
over there.
And they've almost isolated themselves, haven't they?
Yeah. That's right.
Just all around all the borders.
Sydney's not good at all apparently at the moment either. So. Yeah, so they live in Brisbane, so it's not, you know, we have to go to Sydney then to fly on to Brisbane, so it's a bit of a trek, but we won't be able to. When we were out there, we couldn't get through, we were coming via the Singapore back, and they wouldn't let us through. They said, no, you can't come through, so there's no point you even taking off. So we ended up another 3 weeks there, but it was nice because I was still with my sister, but it's quite a long time. We were with friends, and that's a long time to be with friends as well, I tell you.
Well, that says a lot.
That's really awful to say. I mean, 2 months with friends, you know, living under the same roof.
Yeah. Very true.
We still talk to them, though, I might hasten to that.
Well, that's something.
Yeah, it's quite.
What's your problem, Sue? You all right?
Yeah, my monitor wouldn't switch on, so I had to find some batteries for the remote control, and then it wouldn't switch on, and I had another fiddle, and it switched on, so thankfully it's all sorted now. Should be fine. Sorry about that. That was a bit of a...
Your concert go, all right?
It was really good, thanks. Yeah. Unfortunately, we got cut by about half, because we were right in the middle of a set, and the last... people were the headliners, as it were, and they wanted to start and finish on time, which was really annoying because the people before us overran. So, so we had to cut our set short, but there you go. That's what happened. We had a good time. Everyone seemed to be having a good time. So, it was lovely. Good. Thank you. Yeah.
Was that the one that Lynn came to? Was that the concert she was coming to?
I didn't see her, though.
No, mind you, there's probably lots of people there. But
yeah, I wonder if she did come in the end.
You took down the directions, I think.
Yeah.
Which concert was this?
It was a gig. It was called Rocking in the Wreck. It was all outside. We were on a lorry. We were performing from the side of a lorry, which was really cool. But unfortunately, the band that were like a sort of, I don't know, 9-piece band or something, were all setting up while we were performing. And we were literally on the corner of this lorry. It was hot.
They weren't tuning up as well, were they?
Yeah.
No.
They were doing everything. I mean, obviously, they weren't plugged in. Yeah. But it was a bit unprofessional. I am blaming the tech guy, because basically if the tech I went down there a bit earlier and he wasn't there at all, and then I went down again to see them after I'd been to the dentist, and basically he just turned up, and he didn't say make sure you're back by 5 before, you know, to set, put all your stuff on stage and to set up. He wasn't in control at all, so it was a bit naughty, really, because there was a guy on before us. I don't know if you've heard of Angus Morton. I don't know, he's in Paddock Wood, but he's on the autistic spectrum, but he's got this amazing, amazing voice. And he sang a couple of songs, one of which was our Joseph song, you know. I close my eyes.
Technicolor of Dreamcoat or whatever.
Yeah. And it was so good. He's got this wonderful, lovely, rich voice. Anyway, and he was really nervous, so I thought, well, there's no way we can set up behind him, because it's just not done. It's not the done thing. And then we got on stage for setting up, and they said, oh, can they set up the big band? And I'm like, what can I say? You know, we had an hour, or allegedly had an hour. And, so I don't know. It was a bit funny, really, but there you go. There's lessons to be learned. What's that, Sally?
That's show business for you.
Yeah, it is. These things happen and you just have to get over it.
Years and years ago, I was doing an open air concert, an old time, in a sort of fete and festival, a big sort of event.
Yeah.
And every time I went on to sing, a helicopter took off doing the helicopter ride. So I was swimming against the helicopter.
Oh, that's really dreadful. That's dreadful.
I've never forgotten that.
Yeah. Oh, goodness. Well, at least we didn't have that, I suppose.
Morning, Richard.
Morning, Richard. Excellent. So, are we about ready to make a start, do we think?
Morning.
Good morning.
I saw you on Facebook.
Oh, did you?
No, don't say that. It was a good picture of you and your wife.
I didn't see that. What was that on?
Yes. You've got something to tell us, haven't you?
Yeah, I am the new president of Tunbridge Lions Club for the year.
Yeah. Oh, congratulations. Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
which is why, unfortunately, I was a bit late this morning, because we had our first main committee meeting last night, and one or two things came out of that which I had to sort out this morning. So my apologies for being a bit late for it.
Oh, dear. That's the thing.
Other allegiances. Ba-boom. Other allegiances.
Yeah, well done. Oh, well.
What we're trying to do is I don't know whether you know, but the Angel Centre vaccination centre is closing at the end of the month.
Yeah. And heard it on the news.
Yeah, we're trying to set up a celebration party and invite as many of the NHS staff and volunteers that we possibly get.
Oh, so, that would be good.
Yeah. But at the moment, we've got about 180 of them.
Sounds like a super spreader event to me.
Yes.
Yes.
Be in the car park, such a thing as well.
Yeah. We're talking to Hadlow Manor tomorrow to see whether, because we use their facilities for our main meetings and everything. So if it's a nice evening, we can be indoors and also outdoors.
Like yes.
Going round and round in circles a bit anyway, but we'll see how we go.
Oh, well, that's
you're well. You're all well.
Yeah, not too bad, yes, thank you.
Good. Yes, thank you very much. Yeah.
Good, and you're getting all better now, are you, Richard?
Oh,
pretty
yeah.
Completely recovered.
I forget that I've had all of this, really. I'm just carrying on totally as normal.
Yeah.
That's good. Brilliant.
Yeah. That's really good.
Apart from the singing voice, which desperately needs to get back into trim. But
do some exercises then, Richard.
Well, yeah, but it's not just that, is it? It's whatever. Yeah. Yeah.
What? It's not that, it's...
Hey?
What is it then? Getting out there and singing
in groups and working together. That's the main thing I'm missing at the moment. Mm-hmm. But as you all are, so.
Well, yes, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's a difficult one when we don't really know what's going on, do we, at the moment? And it's, you know, there's a lot of science going on, isn't there? It's all very well singing outside, you know, but I'm not sure about singing inside yet, really, personally. I don't know. What do you all
think? They talked about singing.
They have said that it's okay, haven't they? I thought it had all been agreed now.
Yeah.
The choirs could restart.
Oh, what, inside?
Mm.
But I think it's all also about how people feel personally, isn't it?
Mm. Yeah.
Because it's...
So, in my absence, have you had a chance to talk about rehearsals and things?
No.
Were you waiting for me?
Waiting for you, Richard.
Right, okay. I've contacted the Free Church, well, the Baptist Church, as it is now, and also the Upper Church, where we've done our concerts. And they are both available on Tuesdays. And they're working on 20 quid to cover heating costs and all that sort of thing.
That seems
very cheap.
Yeah, no, I think it's very, very reasonable, really.
Yes, absolutely.
So we just got to. I'm talking to them about September. I'm not rushing things at all, but we do need to try and get things going again.
Yeah.
I don't know what you guys think. Hannah is particularly keen to have some opinions. Hi, John.
Yeah, I just wanted to interject here. One of the things about working at the hospice is that the music is held there and the facilities for reproduction is there, if you know what I mean, as far as music is concerned. And if you decide that you're going to use another venue, those facilities so you've got to think about the spare copies of music, how you're going to get them there, or what you're going to use. So this is something that needs to be carried in the logistics of all of this.
Yeah.
It's a nice thought, going to the upper church, which is freezing cold, whereas the Baptist church isn't, you know, but it's much nicer if we could use the hospice, especially if we were able to use the waterfall room.
Yeah, but John, this isn't an interim measure at the moment, because I think Hannah
will... I understand that.
Yeah, I'm just very keen to get us together in some way or other. And while hospice sorts itself out, it's got a lot to sort out, and whether we are going to be welcomed back in there to rehearse or anything. As far as the music goes, now once we've established what we're doing, we generally have it out anyway, and either I'm carrying it in a box or Hannah's got it in a box, so I don't think that would be a major problem there. But Hannah, what are your thoughts? I know you've got particular concerns about the hospice, haven't you?
Yeah, well, we are due to have an update today, which will lay out the hospice's interpretation of the new government guidance. Now, it's very possible, because of the nature of the hospice, that they won't relax everything the way the government is. I know for a fact that at the moment we won't be able to sing at the hospice.
Yeah.
So I would say, in terms of the hospice, leave that until I give you any further information, because I'm always in talks with Paul, the care director. Obviously, the hospice day service isn't due to open until January. They haven't told me that we're going to be opening any earlier, and it's sort of getting to, you know, we're nearly in August now. So I think it's highly unlikely that we will. But when we do reopen physically, there is more of a chance then that choir will be allowed to return as well, but probably as a limited capacity, I would imagine. So even, you know, the waterfall room, it's a big room, but we were always quite squeezed together, weren't we? So I wonder whether we won't be able to have that many people. Anyway, that's like going into the future. So I think at the moment we need to work off of hospice is not doable for now until I kind of let you know otherwise. I'm happy if you want to meet up somewhere else, but I think it's important that Paul knows about it.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
So whatever we kind of decide today, I'll relay to him and see what he's... I mean, the chances are he'll probably say, yeah, that's fine. But yeah, he basically needs to know what's going on, because the choir is part of the hospital.
So I've just muted Francis because of the helicopter or whatever it is going overhead. Just muted you, Francis.
Yeah, that's kind of really what I have to say about that. I'll let you know. I can forward on the new updates from today to the choir. Let the choir know where the hospice is at.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
But in terms of singing inside, I think Sue's totally right. I think we need to... It's a shame not more people came, because I did mention it in both my emails last week and today. But we need to really gauge whether people are comfortable coming back singing in person with lots of people, I think. Otherwise...
Has anybody emailed you back or anything?
No one. I wonder if they've stopped reading emails.
Well, did you just put what? Maybe you need to put a different thing in the sub, and then they wouldn't think it's the choir email, possibly.
Yeah, I'm really sorry.
I must admit, I didn't.
Funny.
Because I'm bad at reading emails.
I don't know whether we got it, Hannah.
I don't know whether we got that. Did you send it with the link that you normally send it with? Because that was the only one we had last week.
You didn't ask for a response, Hannah.
No, I didn't ask for one. I just imagined turn up, I think. But I
can... Oh, right.
Well, okay, let's otherwise we're not going to getting any singing done. Can I suggest, we've got a choice, for a start, we've got a choice of two venues. The top church is obviously, we know it well, and it's got reasonable parking facilities for us to go into. But if we go into September, October, November, hopefully the heating problem will be, if we're going to pay them 20 quid a week, I would hope very much that they're going to have a reasonable heating going for us. Or there's the Baptist Church, which is a nice hall. Do you remember we did a concert there 2 or 3 years ago?
Yes.
It's a nice facility, but the parking is atrocious. But it's a nicer atmosphere in the Baptist Church hall than it is up in the top church. So I think we need to make a decision today from the who we've got, what venue we want to use, and then we say to ask Hannah. So basically, this is a situation we want to take this forward and base ourselves at whatever venue for the time being. Who is up for it? We just need to know numbers to see whether it's worthwhile doing it. And if she's got that information, what we're trying to do, then that might make them jump more. I don't know.
Is there any parking at the Baptist Church?
Yes, there is at the back of the church. There's a small car park.
Well, you get about two cars in there.
Right. The rest of it's in the side streets, isn't it?
So you'd be expecting people to walk and stuff like that. But there's quite a few of us that aren't in Pembury, aren't there? I suppose most of us aren't in Pembury.
Are you talking about meeting like we used to every 2 weeks, or are you?
Yes.
You go back to doing that. Okay.
Go back to the same that we were, and take it through on that basis. So from the parking, I think the parking is an important feature and we should bear in mind. So I'm tending to think more the top church, the main church, as our venue for the period. That will take us up to Christmas concert. And then obviously, hopefully, Hannah will know more about what's happening with Hospice when we go into January. So it would cover us in that period.
Especially if it's only temporary, know.
Yes.
But if we could find out about the heating.
They've asked us to contribute 20 quid towards the heating. They're going to put me.
Shouldn't be too bad then.
No.
Hannah, I just wonder, you don't actually put the time of the Zoom on your letter, and we know it's 10, but not everybody does.
Yeah,
is that why some people haven't come, do you think?
Maybe. I did say
there's it no,
got at the start, but yeah, you're right. I didn't.
There hasn't been a time on for a long time now.
That's okay, because we can talk about it here, and then I'll let them know what we've discussed, and then I'll ask for a response this time, and I'll put a different title, like you said, Sue, in there.
Yeah.
I just think it's worth saying, urgent, we want to hear from you.
If you've got the time, send it out before next Thursday, obviously, to give them time to consider it, because obviously we need their response when we meet again next Thursday, don't we?
I'll do it today.
Yeah, okay. All right, then.
Apologies, so
are we okay that we say that the upper church is our preferred venue then?
Yeah.
I'm not trying to force it.
Upper church.
No, I think you're right.
Do you want a show of hands?
Show of hands. Mm-hmm. So I'll put thumbs up.
Upper church. Oh.
Okay, with either.
Right.
Okay.
Just so we're thinking about how we're going to pay for this, because I know in all our structure up until now, that it's been donations to the hospice, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Obviously, this will be a different situation. If we get charge £1 for rehearsal for the use of the room, and we say to people donate to the hospice in the in on the into the hospice. Does that sound realistic, Hannah? Or?
I'm really sorry. I think I got that, but my internet's very unstable. So what you're saying is you're going to charge.
What am I saying? We charge a pound. Assuming we're going to get 20 people, so we cover there. But the if anybody then wants to donate they can then donate the hand over to you.
I think I got that, yeah. Okay. You've gone again. Why is the
internet's dodgy?
Oh, right, let's try and change it.
Frozen.
I wonder why the internet's so...
on how many respond to Hannah's email, doesn't it?
Yeah, or do a two, like say 150, and then, you know, and then have a reserve if there's not.
Yeah, we can look at all that. Let's see what sort of result we're going to get with the. The comeback message. The only disappointing thing about this is won't be. Sorry.
Frozen.
Anna, hello. You okay.
In my email, shall I mention that it'll be normal time, so 6:30 till 8?
Yes. Yeah. Which is a bit of a problem because Hannah can't join us at that time because she's based down at the hospice. So we just hope that Hannah will be able to find some opportunity to come and join us if you do get going like this.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure there will be some times when I might be able to come and join, but they won't allow me to come in late and I can't do any other evening. It's a bit of a nightmare at the moment. Once uni finishes, it'll be so much easier, but obviously by then we'll probably be back, hopefully by normal anyway, but
how far off is that?
June, end of June, I think.
Next year.
Do we have to start that early? Do we have to start at 6:30?
I think everybody likes it. Especially in the winter months. I agree. It's actually quite nice to. You've still got. Yeah. Okay.
I just don't think she's hearing us properly. She's still. Can you not hear us, Hannah?
I didn't hear anything you just said then. Sorry.
No.
I was apologising. We did get your email. Did you hear
that? Oh, okay.
Okie dokes. Well, shall we make a very quick warm up then and have a little sing?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okie dokie. Right, let's do a few shoulder rolls, sort of, don't rush them, but I was going to say do shoulder rolls and head turns at the same time, but that's not going to happen. I don't think I could cope with that. My coordination is not that good. Well, a few clunks and clicks. Right, let's just do a few.
My chair creaking. Head
turns. Myself.
Oh.
I was clunking. Fantastic. Gotta do it. It's gotta be done. Do it one more time. Three. That wasn't good. Okie dokie. I've bashed so many things lately. Right, let's try some lip trills. So if we can all moisten your lips, that makes it a bit easier, and go. If you have real trouble doing that, you can go like a V sound. So as long as we're getting the, you know, we're stretching out our vocal cords.
You don't have to come.
Oh, is that, you got a little doggy? Oh, it's a little doggy. Sorry, I'm so excited. Oh, want to join in with our warm up?
It was the trills. She made her start.
Like it. He loves it. Oh, he loves it. Oh, I'm so happy. And okay, and we do our lovely stretch and a yawn. And again.
Get down.
Oh, lovely. And the other way. And make sure we're animating our face when we do this. We'll go we're gonna go ooh. And wide. Lovely.
I'll do that with my tooth.
What did you say, Christy?
I had a tooth out earlier in the last week, but she didn't get root out, and yesterday I had to see a dental surgeon to get the root out, so I've got a great lump at the side of my where it's so swollen I can't even get my spoon in. You know, I'm having to suck it off the spoon.
Oh, that leads us to some breathing exercises. So we're going to sip in some air.
Get down. No,
like we're sipping in that soup through a straw, let's say. So we're going to relax everything first and get all the air out first. And then when you breathe in, you support yourself. So when you breathe in, you're actually relaxing your tummy muscles, and then when you breathe out, you're sort of supporting, so you're pushing that air out. So we're going to breathe it all out first, so tense up your tummy muscles, and then we're going to breathe in, with Christine's soup, and then we're going to push it out, and breathe in. Engage your tummy muscles and breathe out. And breathe in. And then we're going to blow it out on a rhythm. Brilliant. Brilliant. Have you got any other ones you want to add in, Hannah? Or shall we start singing?
Maybe we should start singing. We've got 20 minutes left.
I think we, yes, let's do that.
Can you keep on?
Shall we? Do you want me to? Shall I? Because I can hardly hear you sometimes. Let's do it. I will do it. See me scrolling this. Can you see me scrolling?
Oh,
yeah. That's a bit small. I know, but can you see me scrolling it?
Yes, we can.
Good, right. I was just checking I've got the right one. Let's do Oh What a Beautiful Morning, because that's quite a nice starting song. And it has been lovely, lovely weather as well, hasn't it? Just going to try and move this so that you can see. Right, is that okay? That's about right, isn't it? You can pretty much see it. And then there's a little... a word cut off, but I think you can tell what it is. So if I mute everybody to start off with, And then you can come in if you want to, come in on the choruses or at the end if you find it easier. Let's just find the chords. Here it is. Chris and Margaret, would you like to choose a song?
Singing in the rain, but it's not raining. I've got sunshine to rain.
What would you like?
I'm singing in the rain.
I'm singing in the rain. Have we got that? Just checking.
We got that one.
No. Yeah. Oh, we got raindrops keep falling on my head, but we haven't got. Which one would you like? Right.
Raindrops are falling
on my
head.
Don't have that very often. It's... Yes.
No,
in the old song.
The Hospice one.
Oh, yeah. Maybe it's in the old one. Sorry. Yeah, I'm bad. Right. Okie dokes. Let's have a go at this one then. See what wonderful chords are in it. Okay, so if you'd like to join in, come in on the second half. One thing I know, the blues they sent to meet me. It's a bit funny. It's a funny old song. It does speed. It's supposed to speed up halfway through that as well. Yeah. Oh. There we go. Right. Next. Patricia, would you like to choose one? Oh, I've got you on mute at the moment. So, would you like to?
Bring me sunshine. I think.
Hey.
All sunshine.
It's arrived.
Very highly appropriate.
Yes, I saw so.
Yeah, and lovely as well. It's all about the weather in Britain, isn't it? Right, let's do it. Richard, would you like to choose and sing one?
Oh, right. Hang on, don't go too fast.
Sorry.
Not at my age, I can't cope.
Not saying a word.
No. Oh. It just shows my age, Sue. I just know so few on this list.
No, there's hardly any modern ones on here.
Well, yeah, but you know, what do you term as modern and what I
I think, though, there's certain people who prefer classical music to popular music, because there's loads of 60s and 50s songs on here.
Yeah.
And traditional songs and jazz. There's lots of jazz.
You don't know my background. I was very much a family farming boy. I didn't really get involved in music until I was about 8 years.
It's hard, isn't it? You've got musicals. There's a few musicals songs in here. What about the teddy bears? Picnic.
No,
I'll
do that.
No, don't fancy
Hold on, okay.
That takes you know that one.
That takes me back to when I was five. So that's
you remember that one.
You can't forget that then. All of these, a load of these songs are from literally singles that we had that were packaged up for children and, you know, Seekers, all those Seekers ones, Morning Town Ride and things like that. I've just got on singles somewhere. So, right, let's, I'll mute everybody. And if you want to unmute yourself, do you want to
Get after last week? Yes, probably.
If you could.
Start again. If you go down to the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. If you go down to the woods today, you better go in disguise. For every bear that ever there was will gather there for certain, because today's the day the teddy bears have their picnic. Every teddy bear who's been good is sure of a treat today. There's lots of marvelous things to eat and wonderful games to play. Beneath the trees where nobody sees, they'll hide and seek as long as they please, because that's the way the teddy bears have their picnic. Picnic time for teddy bears. The little teddy bears are having a lovely time today. Watch them catch them unawares and see them picnic on their holiday. See them gaily gad about. They love to play and shout. They never have any cares. At 6 o'clock, their mummies and daddies will take them home to bed, because they're tired little teddy bears. Da-da-da-dum. If you go down to the woods
we all ended on a different key, I think. We're getting there. Right. That you'd be able to lead one, or is your internet too unstable?
I mean, you keep cutting out, but I could try.
Yeah, that'd be lovely. And if it all goes pear-shaped, I can take over.
Hallelujah. Hannah, can you do hallelujah?
Yeah.
Excellent.
I did bring my ukulele today, but I don't know.
Oh, excellent. Hallelujah. Have you got the chords?
No, hold on. Let me just have a look. Just double check. I know the chord first.
It's... I can send you a screenshot.
C, A minor, G. Oh, that should be okay. It depends if it's
the better key is in G, but I don't know. G, E minor. But it's up to you.
There was a secret car. Yeah, we can do that. Okay.
That'll be good for Christine, at least.
Thank you. It might be quite high, but we'll have a go. You can go an octave lower.
Absolutely fine. It'd be wonderful. Right, I'm going to mute everybody and then unmute you, Hannah.
Bear with me while I scroll as well. I've heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Want to see your face? I did my best. Okay, sorry about that. Okay.
Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty in the moonlight overthrew ya. She tied you to her kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. From your lips she drew a hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I did my best, it wasn't much. I couldn't feel so much ready to touch. I couldn't come to you. And even though I was before, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
nice too.
Did you all hear me okay?
Yeah,
great.
Oh good,
absolutely brilliant. Do you want to do another one?
Sure, why not?
Finish off, we've got one time for one last song.
I don't mind. I learned, we don't have to do this one, but I learned the Joni Mitchell one because someone asked for it last week and I didn't know it, so I've learned that one. Or
which one?
Something
which one
like both sides now.
Both sides now. Should we do that? Mm. That's lovely. Mm. Did someone leave? I heard a noise.
I know that one.
Okay. Should I mute everybody?
Are you doing it?
You're going to do it, aren't you?
Oh, okay. I'll try. Oh, I haven't practiced it this morning.
Oh,
wow. I'll give it a go. If I lose it, you can help me out.
Okay. I didn't want to put you on the spot.
Shall I? Yeah, okay. Oh, you were frozen. Are you meeting everyone? Hello? Can you hear me?
Right, I'll mute everybody. Something has gone a bit wrong. Do you want me to do it?
Right, I've got it here. Hold, let's see how it goes.
Okay, let's go.
Floors and floors of angel hair and ice cream castles in the air and feather canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, the clouds got in the way. glitter clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's clouds illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and dunes and fairies wheel and dizzy dancing the way you feel. With every fairy tale comes real. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go. And if you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away.
Your ukulele
sounds nice, actually.
Oh, that's B minor. Hang on.
I've got flies coming from me.
B minor, this B. one. Yeah.
Terribly hard.
Very good.
Excellent. Well done.
Thank you, everybody.
So, thank you. Any more notices? Any more news? Or
yeah, we've still got a book. What's the music book we've got? Music Melodies, is it? We've still got a copy of that. Will we still supposed to hang on to it, Richard?
Yeah, hang on to it at the moment. And, we'll get it back into the Hospice library when we can get access to it. So,
right.
Yeah, I've got a load of the Joseph Technicolor copies, which the Hospice bought. I've got them here. So, okay, I must shoot. I've got to go and collect Julie. She's down the hairdressers, so I'll.
Oh, bless her. Lovely. Very lovely. Well, I hope you have a lovely rest.
Nice
of
to see you.
It's lovely to see you.
Take care.
See you all next week. And don't forget to look out for Hannah's email.
Bye.
Okay.
Bye.
See you. Bye.
Bye. Bye.